Hi, and welcome to the History of American Christianity and the Stone Campbell Movement. This video is just an overview of the course, the assignments, kind of what every week looks like. Since we don't go over the syllabus in person, what this is designed to do is sort of give you an introduction to what everything kind of looks like for these next 8 weeks together. And so that's the purpose of this video. Just a quick word about myself. Most of you probably don't know me. My name's Andrew Nichols, but I go by Andy, so you can just call me Andy. That's just a picture of my wife, Mallory, and our little daughter, Sophia. I'm the minister, preaching minister at Hillside Christian Church here in Marshfield, and I am a church history major. It's my field. I did my master's at Lincoln in church history. I did my undergrad at Ozark Christian College. And now I'm studying early Christian prayer practices in the Desert Fathers and the University of Aberdeen in Scotland. So that's a little bit about me, and that's kind of my background, if you will. I'd like to know who I'm learning under and kind of where they're situated in life. Okay. So here there's the two required books. They're not very long. This book written by Mark Knoll, the one on the left, The Old Religion and the New World. I don't make you read every chapter out of this, only the ones that are really relevant to our discussion. Mark Knoll, I probably have 8 or 9 books written by him that I've looked at, that he's written on American Christianity. It's kind of his field, his expertise. And anyway, he's the one for one of our textbooks. Very great church history scholar. And then the second book, The Stone Campbell Movement, A Global History. When you pick this thing up, it looks like a monster. It's a hardback. It's very long. But again, this is one I'm not making you read all of it. So look at what assigned pages there are. There's several chapters you'll get to skip, mostly because this is a book designed for kind of a global approach, and we're focusing mostly on the American Christian side of our Stone Campbell movement. And then there is one other book I wanted to talk about. This book, Scripture First. This just came out last year. Very good book. It's not required that you buy this, but it is a book that I think c causes us to think enough that I'm offering it up as extra credit. Now, what this book is about chiefly is biblical interpretation that fosters Christian unity. It kind of goes through, and it's a different offer for each chapter. It goes through and it offers up some critical thinking about how to approach scripture and unity and what a correct interpretation of scripture is. And all of the authors come from a Stone Campbell background in some capacity, but they really engage it in a scholarly way, in a way that's really helpful and practical. And so that book is going to be offered up for extra credit. And moving on to some of the assignments, kind of the heart and blood behind a lot of our class time each week is after the reading and after the video. And I would actually recommend you do the video first. Just you can do whichever order, the video or the reading first, but after the reading and the video, you're going to have two forum posts each week up on Canvas. The first one will be Thursday night, and this is going to be kind of the initial post for the week after you've watched the video and done the reading. This one will be 250 words, so there is a word requirement for it, and it's a critical reflection. So what does that mean? Well, say we're looking at the Second Great Awakening, and you are reading about crisis conversion and revivals and evidence for our effectual calling, all phrases that we'll look at in the course. And you are reflecting on how that impacts today's ministry and today's altar calls at the end of service, and how most of the service sort of can climax on a decision for Christ. And so you write about Finney, you write about these great revivalists, and how that's impacted what we think is normal in a church service. And I just use that as an example, but this will be a good time to discuss the relevance of what we're reading and what we're looking at together. And I'll do so in the videos, and in this forum post as well each week. So, and at the end of your forum post, for this first one, you're required to have a researchable question. So something you want to know about or something you want to know more about, and it needs to be researchable, meaning that it's not just a matter of opinion to reply to. Now you can, when you are replying to this, you can throw in opinions, but it's expected to have some sort of research with it. So the second forum post after this initial one is by Saturday night. So you have, you know, two full days to do this. You're going to pick two of these initial posts from other students, and you're going to respond to their reflection, and you're going to respond to their question. So that implies that you're going to research and answer their question. These don't have a required word length. I mean, it'll be quite obvious if you've, you know, researched, just even if it's a quick one, research the answer to their question and reflected with them. And ultimately, with forum posts, you will get as much out of this as you put in. On Sunday afternoon, after I preach and go home and take a nap, the thing I'll do every Sunday is I will go through and I'll reply to each and every one of these forum posts, make sure all the questions got answered, and also just reflect with you on kind of what your observances were. So I'll be engaging with this each week with everyone and every post that we have. So moving on to some of the projects, and there's two main projects in this course. There's an interview project. It might sound intimidating, but it's actually, for some, this might sound a little bit easier than writing another paper. But this is designed to get you kind of mobile and interacting with what we're learning about here in the class. So you're required to interview a minister or a leader, and that can mean different things for different denominations. So that's vague on purpose. From a denomination that you're not currently part of. So it could be one that you actually grew up with, or it could be one that you used to be part of, or it can be one that you're not involved with in any way ever, church down the street type of thing. But find a minister who's willing to do this and ask them questions. So it can be done online, meaning you can Zoom it, you can Google Hangout, you can FaceTime for the interview. I only ask that you don't, that you do this in a way that you can talk back and forth. So it can't be done, you know, just through Facebook Messenger messaging back and forth, or it can't just be done through email. You actually have to have some sort of dialogue in the interview itself. And I'm requiring you to ask at least five questions. And I do provide three of the questions in the syllabus. Just to provide you some, you know, one of the questions is what does it mean to be biblical to you? What comes in mind when you think of the word biblical? And those questions, as we go through the course, it'll make more sense. These are questions that are huge in the restoration movement now and have been for a long time. And interacting with other denominations and seeing what you can do together ultimately is what the restoration movement has been trying to do from the beginning. And then after you've done the interview, because this is one of the two main projects, and we're trying to fit 16 weeks worth of material into 8 weeks, keep that in mind. I'm requiring you to write at least 3 pages, recording their answers and reflecting on their responses. So that'll go very quickly. I mean, that part is not a research part. Largely, we're looking for reflections, what you agree with, what you disagree with, what you were surprised by, that sort of thing. And a rubric for that can be found on Canvas as well. So there's a whole lot more information on that on Canvas. And finally, this research paper. The research paper, 10, 12 pages, and you're going to cover all the key concepts of the restoration movement that I have covered in the class. Now, you'll find on Canvas, I have listed out for us the key concepts and that we're going to be discussing in the various videos and in the history of American Christianity. But this paper is designed for you to take all of those, kind of lay them out, talk about their historical context, talk about their significance, and scripture that was used to sort of support these ideas, and to lay that out. So this is a research paper, as the previous one was just an interview one. And with this, I am requiring you to use 10 sources. Now, say, what would you use as a source? Because this is a little bit more specific as a paper. You can use commentaries. John 17, for example, we'll see in the Restoration movement has been a very big passage. And so commentaries on the Restoration movement. You can use original texts. We're going to have us read a few original texts, and you can use those as documents for original sources. You can also use journal articles. We have a great library at Lincoln and a pretty easy access to journal articles and to books and to various documents on the Restoration movement. And so those are fairly easy to get a hold of. Just to throw this out there, the Stone Campbell Journal might be one of the first places you go and look for if you're looking for documents on a specific topic. And we're going to be using Turabian. I have a PDF of up in Canvas of a few of the key pages, and I only put a few of the pages that you actually really want to know from Turabian up on Canvas, because I know it can be intimidating to see if you have the right documentation or not. That's just an example. Notice here on the title of the book, which is one of our textbook, and the title of the book right here, it's not really a straight line, but you get the point. In the title of the book, it is in italics, and it's the first and last name in a footnote, comma, the whole title, and then that's where you begin the parentheses, the city and the state is published, Eerdmans, 2002, and then just page 93, it's just the page number. So wherever you got the actual source, that's where that's coming from. And I will throw this out there too. If you want me to look at your paper and highlight anything that's maybe missing or not correct, if you get it to me 2 weeks before it's due, and maybe just a few days after that, I will gladly read your paper and get it back to you with some recommendations on what to change. So I want you to do well, and I'm not trying to make this difficult. I'll do anything I can to help you kind of along the way. And final. So we do have one test, a comprehensive test, and I know that can be intimidating, but really what I'm hoping to do with this test is to see what you know. I'm not going to try to surprise you with anything on the test, and so it's a very straightforward test, and the study guide that I've put together, if you know, and this is on Canvas, if you know the study guide, you look at the questions, which are verbatim the same questions that are on the test for the short answers, at least. If you know those questions, you will do well. And if you want to, again, if you want to fill out a study guide and sort of say, hey, what are the other things here that I might need to know for the test, you can get that to me, and I will go over it, and I'll make sure you know it, because I'm just trying to test that you know the information. I'm not trying to trap you with some trick questions. It is open note. It's hard not to be whenever it is online, but for that reason, there's going to be a time limit on it. I believe I give you 2 hours to take it, so it's not like a short amount of time, which is way more than enough time you'll need for the test. So it is comprehensive as well. What I would do if I were you is I would have the study guide out while I'm watching the videos, while I'm reading the books, and I would add really relevant information and copy that out throughout the whole 8 weeks so that you're all ready for it when the test itself comes up. Okay, and just a few more things here to cover before we're wrapping up and you can move on to the first week's video. Just as a general rule, communicating in general and any questions or elaborations you may need on something never bothers me. If you need to set up a meeting with me also to maybe go over your paper or anything like that, that's going to be very okay to reach out to me about. Or if you just have a question, it's something you want to look into more. A lot of resources, a lot of information that I just can't include in every lecture, and I'd happily point you in any direction you may want to go in. Second of all, be sure to take the weekly quiz, and the only question on that quiz is how much of the reading did you do? And the answers are pretty straightforward. And on those quizzes, I'll have the page numbers for you that you need to read. Just to give you guys extra time to get the books, the first chapter of the Knoll book, which is the book, the only book that you start out with, so it's pages 1 through 47 of Knoll, I have it as a PDF up on Canvas, so your books can get there on time. But go ahead and order those if you haven't ordered those yet. And finally, the syllabus is the Bible of this course. If you have a question, you can reach out to me, but my answers will always first and foremost reflect exactly what the syllabus says. And that is, that's both my choice and what's required of me, just so that it's all in writing from the beginning. So anything that's needed to be known is on the syllabus. This whole video is just to maybe ease a little bit of the confusion that I know looking at a syllabus, getting shocked with at first, especially if you have more than one course, can do for you. So that's it for this video. If you need any other information, look at your syllabus, but also feel free to reach out to me. And it should be a great semester. I'm looking forward to reflecting with you every week on the forums and getting to know you all a little bit more through this course.